There was a very important document that was made in 1944 called the Sargent Committee Report. This is a blueprint, in a sense, for how education should be for an independent India. Sargent Committee Report said that universal education in India will not be achieved for 40 years. So its target was something like 1985, that we can only think of 40 years span by which time universal education would come. In fact, Gandhi ji ne jab unko kaha gaya ki hum nahi kar sakte hain, unhone kaha tha ki fir to 100 saal mein bhi hamari shiksha mein sabhi bacche nahi aayenge. I don't know if 100 saal mein ho gaya nahi, 70 saal to ho gaye, but somewhere his calculation of time frames was better. Now, it is with this background when we come to the formulation of our constitution. Jab samvidhan ban raha tha to is wahan pe bahut iske upar behas hui. Those debates are also now open. You can look at the constitutional debates, and particularly with respect to education, parliament house ki library mein hai. Uske upar bahut charcha hui, and one of the very important things that happened in those debates is education got linked not only to ki bachchon ko padhao, but it got linked to governance itself. There's a very interesting aspect of that debate where they were discussing not education, they were discussing universal franchise. Kya har ek vyakti ko vote dene ka haq hum samvidhan mein de ya nahi? And you might be surprised that there was no unanimity on this. There were lots of people who said ki nahi, shuru se hi har ek nagrik ko vote dene ka haq nahi hona chahiye. And the reason for that is that some people contended that unless the education levels were compatible amongst the population, then allowing vote to the illiterates may distort the vote and therefore distort the governance system. The question also came up during that discussion, ki agar wo karna hai to kitne saal mein hum keh sakte hain ki sabhi log universal education ke antargat aayenge, to kya hum ye keh sakte hain ki jaise jaise universal education ki taraf hum badh rahe hain, that's how we expand the universal franchise. Ultimately, as you know, the constitution makers finally decided that they will have universal franchise. Sabko vote ka haq hoga. Lekin that persuaded another debate. Agar ye ho gaya, to fir shiksha kab tak denge? And interestingly, there was a draft Article 38, which would have granted a fundamental right to education in the constitution itself. But that was dropped when people said that you can't implement it because of the economic capacity of the state would not be enough to finance this. So the same argument that was given to Gandhi in 37 worked in 48. And finally the compromise was to put it as a directive principle, Article 45, which is not a fundamental right. And the fact that the debate was linked to universal adult franchise, this is the only directive principle which was time targeted. All children up to age 14 shall be provided, not shall be provided, the state shall endeavor to provide them education in a period of 10 years' time. And this was a compromise to say that 10 saal mein universal education bhi hoga, but the adult franchise for which the debate had been there would be equalized in terms of educational attainments of the citizens. We adopted the constitution in 1950, so 10 saal matlab 1960 tak we should have universalization of elementary education. Ab 1960 ke baad jab sthiti kuch badli nahi, to 1966 ke Kothari commission report mein it devoted a large amount of its thinking to this question. But one of the most important things that the Kothari commission did, which even the constitution makers had not done, it talked about the disparity. It talked about the social segregation, which it said that the education system, the school, should try to rectify. So, Kothari Commission ke ek article mein bahut clearly common school system ki baat kahi gayi, ki aisa na ho ki gareeb gareebon ke school mein jaye, ameer ameeron ke school mein jaye, high caste ke schoolon mein jaye, low caste schoolon mein jaye. School should be a space where all sections of the society sit in common, because it will go a long way in creating social inclusion rather than segregation. Lekin Kothari commission report mein hi jab isko implement karne ka section jo hai uska chapter 10 jab wahan baat aayi to aap dekhenge ki jo usme vision unhone prastut kari thi aur jo unhone usko implement karne ke tareeke diye they contradict each other. It recognized that you cannot have all schools of same quality at the same time. So it said 10% schools should be made into good quality to begin with. It said one quality school may be set up in every block of the country. But most important, it recognized that private schools exist and said we cannot include the private schools in the common school system. They will have to be excluded from it. So what happened? Agar pehle do tarah ke school the ki bhai private school hai, Doon school hai, Mayo College hai, ye jinko British public school kehte the. Uske saath mein community based school, DAV school jo chal rahe the. तो एक तरह से तो कोठारी कमीशन ने भी माना कि ये स्कूलों को कॉमन स्कूल सिस्टम से अलग रखना होगा सो दे वुड रिमेन फॉर द एलीट्स फी पेइंग पीपल हु कैन पे फीस व्हेन गवर्नमेंट स्टार्टेड सेटिंग अप सेंट्रल स्कूल्स केंद्रीय विद्यालय इन द बिगिनिंग इट वाज इन अ सेंस इंप्लीमेंटिंग द कोठारी कमीशन रिकमेंडेशंस बट देन इट वाज रिजर्विंग द स्कूल्स फॉर सर्टेन कैटेगरीज केंद्रीय विद्यालय सभी के लिए नहीं होगा सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट एम्प्लॉयज के बच्चों के लिए होगा Therefore, you are now making exclusions. और इसी प्रक्रिया को बाद में 86 पॉलिसी के बाद नवोदय स्कूल हर जिले में एक नवोदय स्कूल होगा जो कि मेरिट बेस्ड होगा सो आइदर स्पेशल कैटेगरी सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट एम्प्लॉयज मेरिट बेस्ड टैलेंट बेस्ड दे हैव ऑल रिजल्टेड इन एन एक्सक्लूशन ऑफ एन ऑर्डिनरी चाइल्ड सो द मोमेंट यू से टैलेंट मेरिट belonging to army, belonging to central government employees, belonging to something. These are all now categories which are exclusive categories and go against the whole notion of a common school system. Say up to 1985 or so, they were private schools but not profit motivated. After 85, you see a rising phenomena of not merely private schools but commercial schools. Where people are getting into education as a business to make money, to make profit. Government has either opened a few quote-unquote quality schools, Navoday, Kendriya Vidyalaya, but what did it do to the mainstream school, mainstream Sarkari school? Beginning 1994, when the Government of India contracted for a DPEP program, which is loans from to begin with World Bank and then from a variety of loan giving multilateral agencies and bilateral, DFID, World Bank, European Commission. Under these programs from 94, it adopted a model which was first started by the Madhya Pradesh government of saying that we don't need to start with a regular school. We can start with something called an education guarantee center. If 25 parents say we want some education, you say, okay, we'll give one teacher and you can run the school under a tree or in a panchayat house or in a mandir or wherever and that will be a school. And the teacher doesn't have to be a pre-trained teacher. It will be a casual teacher. We can be appointed by the panchayat. And the para teacher and the guarantee center school will be a way to expand enrollments. It looked very revolutionary at that point of time. That this would mean rapid expansion of access. But when it was adopted as a policy by DPEP and then went out of Madhya Pradesh to 9 more states, what it meant was that ke pehle se hi ek toota phoota mara hua sarkari school, ab bilkul hi education guarantee center, teacher ki koi training nahi, kisi ko bhi teacher laga do, kahin pe bhi bitha do. So on one hand, there were these spectacular statistics to show enrollments have gone up. But on the other hand, what you saw was perhaps a dilution of quality to a level which is perhaps completely unacceptable. So the bulk of the schools from 94 therefore degraded into this variety of alternative schools, non-formal schools, bahut alag alag naam har state ne diye, and a variety of para-teachers, Guruji, Rehbar-e-Taleem, each state giving its own names. Teachers on 10 months appointment whose job would have to be renewed every year, like casual factory labor. So that's what happened to the bulk of the schools, in which means bulk of the children. People estimate maybe 70 to 75% of the total children. But for the more elite paying class, 25% children, you started getting GD Goenka, World School, Pathways, much beyond even the kind of schools that you would consider, 5 lakh rupee ka fees, saal ka. So the disparities that you see from 94 have increased. This is the situation in which we are talking of a right education bill today. Ab ek kanun kya kaisa hona chahiye jo in samasyaon ka hal kar paye.